Who's that? Me. Take a look at that. Kind of cool, huh? So what is that? A hand? No. This is a mountain landscape with glaciers on it. Alpine glaciers, right? You can tell, obviously, this was real, but there's glaciers there. What we really look at, because temperature's been going up, is what does the world look like without glaciers? So, woo, there we go. And when we're looking at a mountain landscape, trying to determine whether there were glaciers and what they did, we're usually left with something that looks like this, rather than that. Nobody was taking pictures 1,000 years ago. So we have to kind of look at it and figure it out. Well, when we look at this, what you should be able to see, first of all, is let's take a look at where the cirque would be. Cirques, remember, are formed at the head, that's the top of a glacier. It'd be here, 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 all of these areas. This would be a cirque over here also. And when the glacier disappears, don't go away. The glacier disappears, what do we get? We get this bowl-shaped basin. Look at that, bowl-shaped basin. And because indeed, just like that one right there, because indeed it is bowl-shaped, this is where tarns form. Remember, a tarn is a lake that's formed in a cirque. Because it's concave like this, precipitation comes down and it can fill up that concave bowl-shaped basin and make a tarn. Where would the arête be? Arête. Love saying that word. Arête. En français, arête. Les arêtes sont là-bas. So they're right here, right? They're going to be in between the glacial valleys, okay, right there. Because what happens is the glaciers are going along, and as they're scraping and grinding, plucking, abrasion, that stuff, they're just slowly making the landscape thinner and thinner and thinner. So the last thing that's left is this ridge of these sawtooth peaks called arêtes. Or arête, I want to say it that way. Where would that be? Well, if you take a look here, right, ow! Sharp, told you, sawtooth peaks. Right here, you know, those are going to be arête. Take a closer look. See the arête? Arête. Okay. Very good. Then, when the glacier's going through the valley, here, it's easy enough to see that this is a tributary glacier, this is a tributary glacier, this is a tributary glacier. And I want to point out that look at the way that one turns, right? This is the hallmark of alpine glaciers. Because they're in mountains, they follow the valley. The valley turns, the glacier turns. It's not a continental glacier, which would be completely over the top of this. What would be the point in having a model like that? No point, right? So if you look, it's turning right here. So we know this is a tributary glacier right here. This is a tributary glacier, that's a tributary. The question really, don't go away. The question is this. Is this the main glacial trough, or is that the main glacial trough? Now, they're all going to make U shapes, okay, all of them. But the question is, which one is the main one? It's kind of hard to tell when you're looking at this. However, once the glaciers are gone, it becomes more obvious because this trough right here is deeper. That was the main glacial trough. That would have been the main river valley if this is a dendritic stream pattern. And then all the rest of these would have been tributaries coming into that main river valley. And you can see this is the main U-shaped valley. Look at that U. Woo, that's a U, man. Look at that. Wow. There you go. You're right inside that baby. Look at that. Okay. This right here is a hanging valley. This is where you could look and you can see where this glacier would have been dropping into that main glacial trough. This also is a hanging valley over here. You can see that the glacier would have come around like this through the valley and then boom, drops in right there. We've also got a hanging valley right here, dropping in. So all of these are all hanging valleys where you have tributary glaciers entering the main glacial trough above the main floor, the bottom, valley floor, where the primary glacier went through. And usually, or many times, let's say usually, many times what happens is that the water that then reestablishes itself once the glaciers are gone, will be going over a waterfall at the Hanging Valley. And it's called Hanging Valley because it's, I mean, you're, you know, kind of doing this. You know, you're out over here and you're kind of like hanging out over the top, you know, and you're gonna fall, woo, and down you go. Okay, and that's what happens with the water. The water goes over a waterfall. Hope you like that. It's kind of trippy. From this side, looks weird. Not sure I like it. Okay. Let me turn you off right here.